sensational. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Breakthrough Prize co-founder Mark Zuckerberg and architect of the Fast and Furious franchise, the one, the only, Mr. Vin Diesel.
If you've ever parachuted a sports car out of a military cargo plane to land precisely on a remote mountain highway in Azerbaijan, then you'd know fast, accurate, real-time communication is essential for the mission.
Or as a wise man, Xander Cage, once said.
Wait a minute.
I live for this.
Hey. Come on, guys. I thought we were sticking to Fast and Furious references,
but
only.
I knew you'd love that one, man.
I do.
It's like back. That's like.
But we're supposed to stay on that.
All right.
Look, and we were supposed to stay on Fast.
All right.
By the way, we're looking for a really incredible hacker for the next movie. I think we need to get you into it.
All right. Let's talk about that later. Let's go back to science.
Back to science.
All right.
Why we're all here. Movies also require a lot of effective communication.
And that's actually true. You know, when you think about it, just watching a movie actually requires a lot of connectivity. You know, every image that comes into your eye gets turned into a signal in your brain. Every reaction that you have sends a signal from your brain. Whether you're reaching for popcorn or reaching for the remote to switch off a movie.
No one's switching anything over here. We're dropping sports cars out of airplanes. But seriously, you make a valid point. Mark, all these messages run through the nerve fibers, the body's own electric cables, and really seriousness. Multiple sclerosis, these fibers come under attack and critical signals are disrupted.
And for millions worldwide, two-thirds of them women, this can mean memory loss, mobility and vision problems, and severe pain. And our next laureates have revolutionized the scientific understanding of how and why multiple sclerosis occurs.
In the late 1970s, a young doctor, Alberto Ascherio, is saving lives in Africa and Central America. He notices a mysterious pattern among sufferers of multiple sclerosis. Something in the environment may be to blame. Thousands of miles away, a neuroscientist, Stephen Hauser, is finding some patterns of his own. He suspects the immune system's B cells are behind the disease. Through years of grueling lab work, Hauser channels this insight into new drugs that radically improve quality of life for patients around the world. But a mystery remains. Why would immune cells that are meant to defend us against invaders attack the body's own nerve fibers? Dr. Ascherio is on the case. Over decades, he has been carefully tracking the trajectory of a different defense force, United States service members. Until he homes in on the hidden trigger behind the disease of multiple sclerosis, a tiny but deadly invader, a common virus that can spark the misfiring immune attack. This discovery could one day lead to a vaccine that destroys the virus and wipes multiple sclerosis from the face of the earth.
All right, we're now going to meet a woman who can tell us what it is like to live with multiple sclerosis and what the work of these scientists has meant for her.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Justine Fedak.
Twenty years ago, I was in New York City about to attend a black tie event almost as classy as this one. Okay, well, we didn't have Mark Zuckerberg and Vin Diesel, but it was pretty glamorous. My career was flying. I was ready to start a family. I was in great shape. And then suddenly, I was hit by this incredible pain. Was it my circulation? New Spanx? I took a hot bath, jammed my numb feet back in my heels, but 48 hours later, I was totally paralyzed. Multiple sclerosis is a war within the body. Like war, it's not just painful, but random. I would be walking okay, then fall hard. My legs would fail. Sometimes I'd feel extreme numbness, sometimes burning agony, and nothing helped, except maybe tequila. Then I met Dr. Steven Hauser. He told me that fighting MS was his life's work. And if I had the courage to work with him, he had an experimental treatment that he believed could help. His life's work turned my life around. There is peace in my body, heart, and soul. I have no MS symptoms. And I'm back in my heels. I'm a passionate advocate for people with MS, and I'm so very excited that we now know what causes it, and that one day there could actually be a way to prevent it. Thank you, Dr. Hauser and Dr. Ascherio. You are heroes. Your tireless work is changing lives and giving hope.
Thank you so much, Justine. And for the record, you are the true star on this stage tonight.
All right, for establishing the role of B cells in multiple sclerosis and developing treatments, and for revealing that Epstein-Barr virus infection is the leading risk for multiple sclerosis.
The Breakthrough Prize in Life Sciences goes to Alberto Ascherio and Steven Hauser.
I started my career delivering babies and fighting infectious diseases in the tropical forest of Nicaragua and war-torn Mozambique. These experiences brought me to doing research with the hope of helping people who were beyond my immediate grasp. It was a difficult transition. I had doubts on the usefulness of my work, and I missed the gratification of seeing nearly moribund children recover and smile just in front of my eyes. So today is really important for me because I'm finally convinced that my work was useful and I'm ready for the next challenge. Thank you.
I began this journey 47 years ago while caring for Andrea, an extraordinarily talented young woman whose life was destroyed by MS. The achievements recognized this evening, understanding and successfully treating MS, came too late for Andrea, but thankfully not for hundreds of thousands of patients today. This was also the work of many physician scientists who connected the laboratory with the bedside, the NIH that supported the foundational work. Donors and industry leaders who made high-risk undertakings possible, and especially the patients who courageously partnered with us in clinical trials. Without them, this breakthrough would not have been possible. Thank you.